नमस्ते भैया, अद्वैत चिंतामणि सर्वेषां स्वागतम्। जायमानं विषयमस्ति अपरोक्षानुभूति, परमहंस परिव्राजक श्री शंकराचार्य विरचित एवं विद्यामुनि विरचित दीपिकाया समलंकृता। ओम वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभा, निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं, सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मुक्तिभेदविभागिने, व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओम नमः परम ऋषिभ्यो नमः परम ऋषिभ्यः। चंद महोदय, शांति मंत्र और प्रथम श्लोक।
ओम सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहे। ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्रीहरिं परमानंदं उपदेष्टारमीश्वरं व्यापकं सर्वलोकानां कारणं तं नमाम्यहम्।
धन्यवाद मोदी।
धन्यवाद।
इन द लास्ट क्लासेस वी वर डीलिंग विद व्हाट इज अज्ञानम, किम अज्ञानम अतः परम वाज द एंडिंग पार्ट ऑफ ऑल द श्लोकास। सो दे आर द श्लोकास वर कंपेयरिंग बिटवीन द opposite aspects of Atma and Ajnana, Jnana Swarupa, Atma and Ajnana. So, Dehatma Bhavam, whatever is that Aham Deha, Iti Bhavaha, Iti Dehatma Bhava. So, that is the Ajnana. And Atma is not Deha, is what it is being shown by those five slokas. This is the fifth and last one of that lot. And here, in this one also, Acharya, Shankaracharya is bringing the aspects of Nitya Sadrubattum of Atma and Anitya Asadrubattum of Atma. So, Shobha Bhagini, can you read the Shloka and the Deepika?
Atma Nityo Hi सद्रूपो देहेन देहो नित्यो ह्यसन्मया तयोरैक्यं प्रपश्यन्ति किमज्ञानमतः परम्। अत्र सर्वत्र पौनरुक्त्यं पुनः इति वा अत्र सर्वत्र पौनरुक्त्यं अर्थं किं महोदय? पौनरुक्त्यं पुनः
उक्तं मीन्स् पुनरुक्ति तत्र भाव पौनरुक्त्यं मीन्स् रिपीटिङ्ग् द सेम् रिपीटेशन् इस् हेपनिङ्ग् नो सर्वत्र पौनरुक्त्यं न आशङ्का आशङ्कनीया।
अस्तु, अत्र सर्वत्र पौनरुक्त्यं न आशङ्का
आशङ्कनीया
आशङ्कनीया आशङ्कनीयम् आशङ्कनीयम् आत्मनः अलौकिकत्वेन अति यत् न अत्यन्त दुर्बोधत्वादेव दुर्बोधत्वात् एव बहुधा वैलक्षण्यं प्रदर्श्यते परम कारुणिकः श्रीमद् आचार्यः आत्मेति आत्मा नित्यो ध्वंसा प्रतियोगी तत्र हेतुः हि यस्मात् सद्रूपः यस्मात्
सद्रूपः
यस्मात् सद्रूपः अबाध्यस्वरूप रूपः देहः तु ध्वंस प्रतियोगी अत्रापि हेतुः हियस्मादसन्मयो नित्यः हि तत्र किम् अस्ति महोदय
हि यस्मात् असन्मयः अनित्यः
हि यस्मात् असन्
यस्मात्
हि यस्मात्
असन्मयः
असन्मयः अनित्यः असन्मयः विकारित्वेन बाधयोग्य इति अर्थः यस्मात् एवम् आत्मदेहयोः अत्यन्त वैलक्षण्यं तस्मात् तयोः ऐक्यदर्शनं केवलं ज्ञानम् इति
केवलम् अज्ञानम् इति
अज्ञानं क्षम्यतां केवलम् अज्ञानम् इति अस्तु
धन्यवादः भगिनि
धन्यवादः
अत्र सर्वत्र पौनरुक्त्याम् आशङ्करीयम् आत्मनो अलौकिकत्वेन अत्यन्त दुर्बोधत्वादेव बहुधा वैलक्षण्यं प्रदर्श्यते परमकारुणिका श्रीमदाचार्य आत्मेति आत्मा नित्या ध्वंस अप्रतियोगी तत्र हेतुः हि यस्मात् सद्रूपः अबाध्यस्वरूप देहस्तु ध्वंसप्रतियोगी अत्रापि हेतुः हि यस्मात् असन्मयः अनित्यः विवादित्वेन बाधयोग्य इत्यर्थः यस्मात् एवम् आत्मदेहयोः अत्यन्तवैलक्षण्यं तस्मात् तयोः ऐक्यदर्शनं केवलम् अज्ञानम् इति
नमस्ते महोदय क्षम्यताम्
चिन्ता नास्ति चिन्ता मास्तु भगिनी अत्र पदच्छेद अन्वयं पठतु लक्ष्मी ललिता भगिनी
पदच्छेदः आत्मा नित्यः हि सत् रूपः देहः अनित्यः हि असन्मयः तयोः ऐक्यं प्रपश्यन्ति किम् अज्ञानम् अतः परम् अन्वयः आत्मा नित्यः हि सत् रूपः देहः अनित्यः हि असन्मयः तयोः ऐक्यं प्रपश्यन्ति किम् अज्ञानम् अतः परम् Atman is indeed eternal and of existence nature, while the body, any object that is as seen, is ephemeral and a non-existent in nature. To think these two as same, what else can be the height of foolishness?
Dhanyavada Bhagavan.
Dhanyavada.
See, here the Satrubhatvam Eva and De Atma is Satrubha. Sadeva Somya Idamagra Asit Idi Upanishad Bhajanam. That Atma is the Satrubha. Sat means existence. And that is the nature which is being experienced in and out of everything. Whereas Deha is Anityaha, because we know that one is Drishtatvad Anityatvam Bhavati. What is being objected is effect of Utpatti, Sthiti, Vinasha, the three avasthas which happens in anything which is objectifiable or seen as could be objectified or experienced as a source of Indriya Gojaratvam. Now, Deha if it is and it is anityam and asanmayah. Asanmayah because even though we feel the experience of the deha, deha is said to be asanmaya. How do we say that? The main reason asanmaya deha is because at any point of time, if you look or observe the deha, deha means all the dehas, sushma sharira, stula sharira, and indriyas or karma indriya, jnana indriya, anything which you look at, we look at it, you will find that they are not always remaining in the same state of affairs. We may feel a continuity. Continuity is not an aspect of sat. Now, for example, in one of the Prakarana Grantha, we call it nadi or a river as an existent part, existing thing. As a river, what we call it is existing in it's in utility, but in reality, you cannot touch the river twice is the famous statement which you make. We all heard about it because water is continuously flowing. And that water, without water, there is no river. And is the water the river? No, because water is always changing. So, even though there is an apparent reality to the river, it is asanmaya, because there is no reality of anything in the aspect of river. Even what we call it as bank is land. What we call it as the water body is continuously changing. But there is a utility, arthakriyakaritvam, for the river. Because of the arthakriyakaritvam, in the prapancha or in the alaukika world, we call it is real. The river is real. Now, in which aspect of the river is real? We know the real or the satya is, sat is defined as trikalabhaditam, yadna vyabhijarati. These are all the definitions which is being given to what is sat or satyam. That which doesn't change, or even that which remains without any modification or a change in all the three, Buddha, Bhavi, and Vartamana, all the three kalas, if it is unchanged, then only when we can say that this is Sat or Satya. Whereas in the case of a river, when we say Asanmayaha, we know that reason why it's saying. Same is the case with anything which we see in the world outside, including the deha. That deha also goes through growth, decay, and death. We don't see the birth because we start seeing only after the birth of the body has taken place. Only we come to know about the body. So we cannot say we saw the birth. But at least from seeing others, we are assuming that this also should have had a birth. So from all that thing, we can assume that Srishti, Sthiti, Laya is the Satyatvam of Deha. Whereas Atma is Nitya. And why does it is Nitya is explained in the next sloka in detail. Now, what does Vidyaranyamuni explain to this is that Atra Sarvatra panuriktim na ashanganiyam atmanaha alaukikatvena atyanda durbodhatvat eva buddhya vailakshanyam pradarshyate paramakarunika acharya. So here he is repeating in the fifth verse the same aspects of vailakshanyam of atma dehayoho. So atma is prakashava. Deha is not suprakasha. There is no way which Deha can know itself without Atma. There is this what is called Sadbhava and Asadbhava. In the other slokas, we saw the different aspects of the Deham and the Atma. Now, even though it is a Punarukti, which is dosha as far as Shastra is concerned, here, Acharya is not worried about Punarukti Dosha for a text, because his industry is in teaching that the truth, what should be known, because kim ajnana mataparam, there is no bigger foolishness among us. So punarukti, you know, it can be removed in only in such a hardened, you know, place. If a mirror gets soiled or thing, if one brushing of the dust on the mirror may not clear it. We may have to use some wet water or a soap water to clear the accumulated dirt. Same way, punarukti is not a dosha when it comes to atmajnana. So Acharya says, Atmeti, Atma, Nitya, Dvamsa, Apratiyogi. Now the Pratiyogi is a typical Vaiyakarna. No, Nitya, Nyaya Vaisheshika terminology. Pratiyogi is what is called the one creates abhava. Now, Bhutale Ghadava Nasti, when something is said that abhavatvam of Ghada is created by the Pratiyogi Ghada. So, Pratiyogi Asti Cheteva Abhavam Bhavati. Now, Dvamsa Apradiyogi. Atmaha Nitya. Nitya is being defined as Dvamsa Apradiyogi. Dvamsa means destruction. And Apradiyogi means it is not the one who causes Dvamsa. So, therefore, it is Dvamsa Apradiyogi. Tatra Hetu. That is the Hetutvam of the Apradiyogi word. Yasmat. Sat Rupa Abhadya Swarupa Dehaha Tu Dvamsa Pratiyogi. Now here Dvamsa Pratiyogi is Atma, whereas Dvamsa Pratiyogi is Deha. So Pratiyogi means, as I told you, is the Abhava. Dvamsasya Bhava Bhavam only is seen in the Deha, whereas not in the Atma. Thereby, Dvamsa Apradiyogitvam Atma Hetu, whereas Dehatva Dvamsa Pratiyogitva Hetu Bhavati. Yasmat Samanya Anitya Vigaritvena Bodhayogya Ityartha. So, therefore, Samanya Bodhayogya Anitya Vigaritvena, only the Deha is known. Yasmadevam Atmadehayo Atyanta Vailatshanyam. Because of these two, Anityattvam, Vigarittvam, all these things are seen on the Deha, whereas Dvamsa Prayodhittvam Atma Nityaha. Then comparing these two are Aham Deha, Dehatma Bhava. That is the typical terminology which is used in the Atma. So, in fact, I remember the first question when Vamshi asked it, that we limit ourselves to the Sharira and why the skin is the level of identification, Deha, if you still remember that question. So, the Deha Tadatmyam, Atmana Deha Tadatmyam Eva Avidya, Kevalam Ajnanam Iti. Why it is Deha Ajnanam? Because Dehasya Swabhava Anitya Anityatvam and Vikarityatvam, whereas Atmasya Nityatvam and there is no Avikari. So Idaredara Adhyasa is what is cause of the Ajnanam. What qualities of Atma is superimposed on the Deha, and what the qualities of which should not be imposed upon Atma is imposed upon Atma, and think that both of them are same. Aham Atma. When you say Aham, Idam Shariram Atma, that thought is what is called Ajnanam, Kevala Ajnanam. So with this, he has completed the Ajnanasya Lakshanam. Any questions we have from the last class also? We discussed about the Aham Bodham and where the Aham Bodham comes, and here this is the Satyatvam, Sat Bhavam, and how does that is being felt in every object. We experience Sat in every iota of the world, and we say that sattad asti, nothing is, we don't say nasti. Whatever we are experiencing with indriya gocharatvam, we call it as tadasti, right? We don't say that is not there. But this astitvam or the satta of those objects, is it of the objects? Because objects are vikari and anitya. Then why are we feeling the satyatvam in that? Anyone?
Come again the question, Mahodaya, once again.
We feel satyatvam in everything in our day-to-day life, no?
Asso. Hmm.
But at the same time, we know that the satyatvam is what is not the reality, because deham has also changed, vikarityam asti. And there are, the srishti sthiti laya, the three, or the shad vigaram, and is happening in every object which we see.
Okay. Hmm.
But we feel that there is a reality in it, or the satyatvam.
In the objects? That's what you are
asking? In the objects as well as the deha, including the deha, everything.
It's all part of the consciousness. I mean, mobile and immobile, that's what it is, right? Like, it's like immobile and all of it is composed by one Chaitanya only, right?
It's Maya, no?
Iterator Adhyasam is the reason for it.
Is the?
It is Iterator Adhyasam. That is the reality of the colors existing on a paint is not the colors are permanent there. The permanent is the substratum, the canvas in which the colors are appearing. The fact of that unchanging substratum of the paint, the canvas, is passed on through the colors, and then we feel the painting is not moving or fixed or real. The color was superimposed onto a canvas which didn't have color. Right? Same way, every object what we see in this world, there is a nama rupa adhyasam of the object on the existence of which is the substratum on everything. For example, if we take ghada, now mrit eva satyam, but ghada as an instrument of pot, as an instrument you can hold water or store things or you can cook in it, all the artha kriya karita means utility or our day-to-day transactional efficiency of that product is there. But that product has no reality or no satta as ghada, as a pot, without the reality of the mud having a reality which is in along with the pot. That name and the form of the mud, when it is changed into a pot, you get a utility factor. But the existence and the reality of the pot is not of the pot, but of the mud. That is being superimposed onto the pot, saying that the pot is existing. The pot is not existing, the mud is existing. Is it clear now? Same way, every object in the world has a nama, rupa, utility, but the existence factor of that or the reality factor of it is not of that nama, rupa, artha, kriya, karitu. That is because of the substratum on which those objects become aware to us. If we remove one by one from the objects, aspects of what is brought in to get the name and form, you will at the end of that you will say that, okay, even this is removable, that process is called neti neti. So when you do that removing of that aspect also, we enter a state of that, even though the name and form doesn't have a reality, there is an existence, a reality which, on which we imposed upon the name and the form, nama rupam. That is vacharambano vikaro namadeyam vrittigatteva satyam, in that Brihadaranya Upanishad in the Chandogya Upanishad Vakyam. So that is what it is. This itaretara adhyasam is the reason for us for this deham atma iti atnyanam. Okay. Can we move to the next sloka? Or any question?
Yes. Mahoday, that means like say a stone is supposed to be insentient and it's jada, but it has a reality because it is superimposed on the substratum. Is that what it means?
The stone has a name and a form which is,
yes,
which can change, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
So that which can change is not the reality.
It's not real. But like you said, it has some transactional reality. We can see it, we can feel it. So is it because it is superimposed on the unchangeable substratum?
Yes. That knowledge of existence, which is knowledge and existence, is not different. If a thing is existent, it's because of this knowledge of existence is mixed and together we feel it. So even the stone per se goes through modification,
yes,
the reality of the stone before the modification and the after modification, the reality which was the stone becomes, suppose it becomes an idol or a lamp or an object, that,
yes,
reality still remains in the object or which has been modified into it.
Yes.
So there is a commonality between the two. The stone,
yes,
when it was lying as a stone, didn't have a shape or a form. We called it as a stone, but
yes,
it got modified into, say, a what you call it, an idol or an artifact. The,
yes,
reality which was there in the stone remains unchanged, even when it was stone, remains same as artifact. Only the name and the form has changed.
Yes.
But what happens is that we are so much confused in our day-to-day transaction that we have a feeling that there is a separate reality as a stone, as a separate reality of the artifact or an idol, which is made out of that stone. But we forget that it is a common of the common reality itself is in which these changes happen. Not on the stone, nor not on the artifact. Because that which changes cannot have a reality, you know.
Yes. Another question, Mahoday. We say everything,
yes,
is manifestation of Brahman.
Right.
So, like, say, trees and rivers, they are not,
right.
I mean, a river is not sentient. But it is still manifestation of Brahman because of Maya?
No. See, first of all, we should not consider Chetanatvam, or what is called the aspect we see of life in an object, as the Chetanatvam or Atma or,
yeah,
Brahman.
Right.
It is not.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So what happens is, in the case is that Brahman, what we think should be first of all clear in our mind as to what we are talking about. Brahma, Atma, Ekata is like how we mentioned in one of the earlier classes that it is the same water of the ocean which is in the sea or which is in the river, which is in the pond or which is thing, the water per se has not changed, but the name and forms have changed. When it is a river, we say it has a movement, so we call it as life. When it is remaining in a kupa or a well or a pond, it doesn't have a movement, so we call it as lifeless. And I'm giving an example, because to show an object, because there is no other object which we can show. So when the movement of a thing like a human being or an animal, the movement takes place, we feel life is there. But when a stone or a tree or a mountain or a river or a pond is a thing that we call it as insentient, is a part of the atmyana. Why it is said it is all out of Brahman or Brahma eva? It is not out of Brahma. Brahma eva. Brahma eva bhavati. All is because Brahma is what we should understand first. That satyajnanam anandam, that lakshanam, even though we use the satyajnanam anandam, we are still conditioned by our limitation of thought, is what is satyam, what is jnanam, what is anandam. Do we know jnanam which is other than an object, without an object? Anantam is something which our mind cannot comprehend. Infinity we cannot comprehend with our mind. Normally in our day-to-day life, we say it as infinity. But infinity is nothing which is comprehensible by our mind. Still we do the transaction which is saying anandam. Now, satyam has been defined as that which doesn't change. So that which doesn't change means it has to be real, whether we are there or not, whether that was there. Now, our lifetime compared to the lifetime of a huge animal like an elephant or even a tortoise, which lives up to 200 years, our life is only half of that. But there were other animals which were living more than 400, 500 years. Compared to that, our life is only 100 years. So, in a relative term, even our life, what the deha which we are holding, is only minuscule in the terms of ananda kalam. When you take a kalam as ananda, in infinite time, in that aspect, the life which we think as our life itself becomes even a dot, or even, I mean, in what you call, not even measurable into the time scale. So what happens is that ananta avastha is of Brahman. The jnana avastha, which without the object we cannot even consider what is that, like that. And these two are always existing, whether we are existing or not. So that is the satyam aspect. That is why these are all tadastha lakshanam, or the indicative qualities of Brahman. And in such a Brahman, all these are appearing. When we say that, is that the reality what we feel in the objects is not of the object, because they are all nama and rupa only. The reality what we feel is the reality of the substratum of Brahman, from it, from where that nama rupa appears. The utility, artha kriya karitam, or the utility, is based on the transactional requirement for our day-to-day living. There are so many objects which are lying in the world which doesn't have a utility at all. Does that mean they are not existing? No, they are also existing. It is not in our vicinity, or which is far away, or things which we don't know even exist in different countries. We don't even have the knowledge about that. So that doesn't mean the artha kriya karitam is limited to only to the items which we are dealing in a day-to-day life. And then coming to the sat avastha. Now, sat is something which we feel that as existing, because for my period of life, it has a reality compared to me. Suppose if the house in which I was born and the house in which I die, the house has a reality more than me, I superimpose on the house. Even though I know that the house was built by somebody, it can get destroyed or decayed or fall down someday. But for me, as far as I am concerned, the reality on the house is superimposed by me, because for me it is a real aspect. But if you dismember that house, what it is? It is made out of bricks, cement, wood, steel, glass, anything which you want to name it. And each one of them you can further dismember. It will become mud, or it will become wood, or it will be. So, Sangadam is a reality when it is being utilized. Like the Sangadam of different particles of mud is the reality of the pot when it is being used. The reality of that pot is on the particles of the mud with which it is made. Same way, we feel that this life which we are experiencing is real only because we feel that, you know, during that our lifetime, there is a reality which we are experiencing. That is because our mind is the one which is fooling us. It is not allowing us to go beyond our sensory inputs, that is Indriya Gojaratva. And there are Indriya Agojaram even in the world outside, which we know that can be measured through ultrasonic or, you know, radio waves or things like that, which are all extension of there, but they have to be converted into the five Indriyas which we can measure with. If it is in the input which is not within the five sense organs which we have, even that conversion is not an acceptable conversion for it until we convert it back into something which is measurable. So from all these points, what we think that if you deeply analyze every day to day, every moment of our life, we are dealing with impermanent things as permanent. And there cannot be more, what you call, ignorance to consider that one who knows all these things in that is the Deha, and that Deha is Atma. That is what Acharya is trying to tell through all these slokas.
Mahodaya.
Thank you, Mahodaya. Yeah.
Yes, Mahodaya. Sarvabhuna.
excuse me. Ramana Maharshi always used to say that, some of the, analogies that he would give is, when we look at, like, using this screen that we are looking at as an example, that when we read, we only read the aksharas, we don't see the whiteness behind it, the substratum,
right?
And we never pay attention to it. So in this case, if we think of all those aksharas as us, each one of us, one akshara, so the question, why is everything looking real? To each of those aksharas, all the other aksharas are real, because that is the state of mind. Like the mind is making us think that those are real. So that white background, infinite white background, is Brahman, and these aksharas are appearing, disappearing on it, so that substratum is not affected, Brahman is not affected. So the akshara, instead of looking at other aksharas around it always, if it looks inside, in this case the background, which is pure white and infinite, then it can go beyond. But like we were discussing, the mind keeps it from happening.
Right. In fact, this Shankara Jayanti, Vidushekara Bharati of Sringeri Math, gave an Anugraha Varsha. In that he used a beautiful example of a white paper was given to somebody to write. Says he was just as about to write, he was stopped. That the person wrote a circle inside that white paper. So that man became confused as to where to write, inside the circle or outside the circle. Then he further divided the circle into many circles and squares and all those things. The man was not able to write anywhere. He just kept on asking where to write. He has to just write Om only. But all the while, the person who asked him to write was asking to him to please write. The writing is always possible only on the substratum. neither on the circle nor on the particles which have been divided further into. Because it appeared there, the person who wanted to write got so confused where to write. If he had written any corner and left, I mean, that question would not have arisen in his mind, no? So that these differences which we create with our own mind, like circle, you know, this is India, this is Australia or US, and man, women, all those are the the size and the squares inside that paper which we see created. But the knowledge or the awareness in which all these things is existing is never a acknowledged part by any one of us. Without that knowledge, none of them will be existing. It is in that knowledge, without the objects, Vishesha Vityana Abhava, that is what Brother Arnya Surocharaya says. Vishesha Vityana Abhava is the avastha. That is, Vishesha Vityana means Vishesha Vityanam is the jnanam of anything that is visheshyam. There is an object, then that object conditioned knowledge is Vishesha Vityanam. When abhavam of such things happen, what is left is our pure jnana swarupa. That is what it is to be understood and known, not that knowledge which we get through each of the objects. Because the moment we are conditioning ourselves with the object or the instruments through which we know it, we are limiting that jnana to only to that aspect. But there is a substratum, as Ramana Maharshi said, or as Shankaracharya Vijayabharati has said, or Adi Chandra had mentioned in so many books, or all the Upanishads say that Sarvam Khalu Idam Brahma happens only if you remove that Sarvam as Sarvasya Adhishthanam. So in that explanation of Sarvam Khalu Idam Brahma, Shankaracharya's commentary in the Brother Nivinashas, he says that Sadatmana Sarvam Atmaiva Abhut. Sadatmana. But before that, Mithya. Jagat Mithya. Brahma Satyam Jagat Mithya. That Jagat Mithya will be, the moment Mithya will become Satyam, Sadatmana, if you see that, you look it as a Sat, Sat Swarupa. Sadatmana means Sat Swarupa. As the existent reality or the existence. So it is a matter of contemplation when we say what is Sat. Sadatmana, when we have to think about Sadatmana, that aspect of that existence as a substratum cannot be different from the existence as knowledge also. And when there is no possibility for it to be bifurcated or limited due to the Vishesha Vijnanam, is Vastu, Jati or any of those things, then it becomes infinite, no? When you don't have a demarcation or anything, any conditions which you can put on knowledge with objectifying, that knowledge becomes infinite knowledge. That is why it is called Satya Jnana Anandam. Right?
Yes. Yes, Mother.
Right.
Mahode, there, Dvamsa Apratiyogi. Apratiyogi means you had told something. What is that? I did not get it. Dvamsa is you're destroying it. Apratiyogi is he's not doing it. What is it exactly?
No, Pratiyogi is the subject which can create an abhava.
In the sense, can you give me an example? Because I'm not clear on that word. I'm not able to get that word.
No, gada abhavasya pratyogi gada.
Gata abhavasya pratyogi gata. In the sense,
gada abhavam can happen only if there is a gada, no?
Okay, right, taken. Huh.
So pratiyogi of gada abhava is called gada.
Okay, but then dvamsa apratiyogi means what?
Okay, now let us take pratiyogittum, aprayogittum of nityattum or atma.
Okay.
Now atma cannot be a pratiyogi because atma doesn't have an abhava.
Okay, fine. There is no abhava for atma. Right, taken. Ha. Okay.
So atma is apratiyogi.
Astu.
Now here dhvamsam bhavati chedeva abhavam bhavati.
Ha. Ha. Oh, astu.
Therefore dhvamsa apratiyogi atma. Nityaha.
Oh, astu. Apratiyogi is which oh, okay. Dvamsa apratiyogi atma astu. Dvamsa pratiyogi is ghataha. You can say that, right?
Yes. Dvamsa pratiyogi is ghada, deha, kimapi vadatu. Whichever can you can be. Because all other things can have abhava.
Right. Atma cannot have abhava. That's right.
That is why atma nityaha dvamsa pratyogi tatra hetu. This hetu, pratyogi, these are all typical vayagrana, nyaya vayagrana definitions. So, we are not very familiar with those terminologies. See, because hetu, vyapti, lakshana, and then vyapti, I mean, all these are all typical, you know, anumana. What you call instruments of anumana.
Right. Okay.
Yatra dum vanna parvadam vannivan is a statement. Yatra yatra dhuma tatra tatra vanni is a vyapti. Hetu. Like the all those definitions are very it's a hair splitting arguments are there in the Nyaya.
And Sanmayaha is also what? Satmayaha, that is Satmayaha.
Sanmayaha is Satmayaha. Sanmayaha is yes, Chinmayaha, Sanmayaha.
Sat is basically existence, right? Sat is basically existence and it's just existing. That's what you meant to say, but Satmayaha, Sanmayaha?
Sanmayaha means it's Ghana, Sanghana or Chinghana. Because there is nothing other than that in it, no? When you say,
okay. If you say Sat Chit Anandam, there Sat is also Sun, I mean, that is also Sat only, right?
Right. See, what happens is that Sun, Sat Mayaha, what happens is when we say Sat Mayaha, other than Sat, when nothing else is there, then it is called Sun Mayaha, no? Chinmayaha.
Is it like Parve?
No, Parve, see, there is that is a very, very this thing which normally will get into a confusion. The moment pervaded means you need something to pervade in. The typical example of that, even though Aidwate also uses that, Tile Tailam. In a seed, how the oil is spread. But for pervasiveness, you need a substratum, then only you can pervade, no? But what happens in this, there is no substratum, the substratum itself is a pervasive, I mean, it's everywhere. Then we will use it as a, what do you call, as a wrong terminology that san mayaha. To become maya, there should be something else in which it can be maya, as you say, spread, pervaded.
But for the reality as we see it, the maya effect or maya that we see, that there it can be said, can it be said that it's pervaded, maya is pervaded by, there can it be said, chinmaya, it's
no,
there is no pervading for Brahman because he has nothing else to pervade. He himself is everywhere, every moment.
Right.
But for the Jagat, Jagat is pervaded.
Okay. Okay. I'll ask you a question. Where does the space pervade?
In itself. But like if we look at the sky, which is infinite actually.
Sky is not space. Sky is not space.
No, as an example, a cloud is in it, but cloud, can it be said that it's pervaded by the space?
No, the moment you see a cloud, it is localized.
Right. No, like as in Srishti and Brahman, that's what I was referring to.
No, that is why even though the terminologies are used like Chinmayaha, Sanmayaha, all the Anandamayaha, all this Maya word, when the moment they use it, there is a diminishing or what you called bringing down that from a Nirguna Rupa to a Saguna Rupa because of our limitations of our mind. It is not that that is a reality. That is why the Satchit Ananda is a Lakshana Vachyam. Why we do we say that? We cannot say because it is avachyakam. So that is the state where the mind or the words cannot comprehend that satyam. But at the same time, the student can get confused as something which is being told is as shunya or anitya or that which is, doesn't exist. But at the same time, you have to say, no, it is there. That is why the word sat is used. That is where the shunyavadins of Bauddha Matam got confused between the Vedic terminologies, anandam avyaktam, that is the particular seventh sloka of Mandukya Upanishad. Anda pratnyam, bahi pratnyam, na vaisa pratnyam, na pratnyaraganam, anandam avyayam, achindyam, avyaktam, arupam, alakshanam, ekatma pratyasaram. These are all the type of definitions that Upanishad gives. Because when the moment you say that there is a where Saguna Rupa which is being brought, but the moment say you say it as a negative thing, that that is not, then you are opening up the infinitude of it. Avikari, when I say avikari, means vikara rahitam. Now, vikara rehitam, to comprehend, you need something which is vikara, vikaravan, asti cheteva, avikari iti artho jayate. Right? Same way.
I think I understand that because we can only describe something using forms and shapes and things like that. We use that, like we were discussing the other day, tatastha lakshanam is what. How we refer to Brahman as Chit Satchit Ananda, but right. he's not those also. He's beyond because there is nothing. He's just existence and nothing else, which we are. But pervading in, I was referring to like in the Jagat, in this reality that we seem to be experiencing right now. Can it be used like that?
No,
because this is not the reality. This that part I understand, that this is not real. It's only appearing, and because we are connecting with it through Deha, it feels real. In reality, there is nothing other than Brahman. But so, in what way do they use Chinmaya?
That is why these are all Tadastha Lakshana Vachakas. Chinmaya means. Sanmayaha, Chinmayaha, all the words are used as a Tadastha Lakshana because in technically if you use that word, the Vayakarana can break it up and say that Kasmin Adhikaranam Kim, right?
Mm-hmm.
But for when you say that in itself, then they will again question you, why should you say then in Maya? Why don't you say that?
Mm-hmm.
If it is chit. But if it is chit, now chit, the moment we say chit, we cannot identify chit without an object. Now, objectless awareness.
Right.
Mm. Yes. The objectless awareness, the moment we say objectless awareness, we cannot comprehend that awareness which is objectless. An object or a substratum or anything that is filled with objectless awareness, then how do you say is it? The moment the question will come again, no?
Hmm.
So that is why, even though we use Chinmaya, Sanmayaha, Anandamayaha, all those words, it is only to indicative of that truth in which everything remains. Now, the only through which that closest which all the Upanishads, there are almost about three major Upanishads and then about five or six minor Upanishads which indicates that the only place where we can somewhere closely tell you how it may be like is that what you are experiencing in your deep sleep. But it is not deep sleep. That also they will say immediately.
Mm-hmm.
Because the moment they say it is something like deep sleep, immediately we will condition itself to the deha. Because we think the deha is the one who is sleeping. So to ward off that, you know, conditioning, immediately they will say it is not even sleep. Trishudamasu yadvogyam boga bogpasyasyad bhavet. Tebhyo vilakshana sach is what is told. Even that jagrat sopna sushupti tebhyo vilakshana. Without any qualification of that jagrat sopna sushupti, vilakshana. Sakshi, when the word, when the moment you use the word sakshi, kim pasyati, saha kim pasyati. The question will go, no? Sakshi means ikshade. Kim ikshade? If there is nothing to be ikshade, then why do you call it as sakshi? Tatra say, chin matroham sadashiv. Chin matram. So there they have to conclude, say that it is only chit. Neither the chit of that, chit of this, or chit of that, then now or then, or any deshakala, parichinna, vastu, without anything of that. Sadashiva, it is always pure in nature. Because what? Other than that, there is nothing else. Do you feel such a state of experience which is for every one of us, same, similar experience? We can say something similar to your deep sleep, but in deep sleep also don't think that your body is the one who is sleeping. That is why Tebhyo Vilakshana is used in the first beginning.
धन्यवाद महोदय
ओके वी विल स्टॉप हियर नेक्स्ट क्लास ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल हैव टू वी विल मूव टू द व्हाट इज कॉल्ड आत्मनः स्वप्रकाशत्व नाउ दैट इज द सेल्फ एफल्जेंस ऑफ आत्मा विच विल डिस्कस फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट क्लास ओके
महोदय क्षम्यता आई नीड टू लीव धन्यवाद महोदय
यस बगनी
थैंक यू Okay. Yeah, thank you.